Welcome to the show. I hope you're doing well. It's Club Kirby for the 16th of October 2020. A little bit later than usual today. It's about 20 past 3 here in the United Kingdom. So we're just going to get right into it. We're continuing to work on page 24. Of the, I want to say ongoing. It's ongoing in the sense that we're continuing to work on it. The ongoing Kirby comic strip, which actually nobody's seen yet. I'm really a bit conflicted about Sadie's arm here. I wonder if I could bring this in a bit. So I'm obviously a good way into this, working on this particular page now. I still have corrections I'd like to make. I've also got a problem with this particular arm as well, because I think it might be a bit too long. And I don't like the fact that one hand seems disproportionately larger than the other. I'm going to pull this up. To right here. Oh, of course, I've got to go in and add the rest of the fingers. And the other hand as well, this hand I think I'll resize it a bit, make it a bit bigger. Just to sort of balance them out a bit. Even if we just do that. And you may have seen my tweet from earlier about Corinne's face here, and I was kind of going for her. She had a nervous face because Sadie's kind of got her under the gun. And, it wasn't that I didn't mean for it to be quite this goofy. And then I can't bring myself to erase it, so I don't know if it's going to stay like that in the final. In the final piece. But for now, I'm going to leave it that way. The more I look at it, the more it makes me laugh, and I just can't bring myself to change it. I thought I was done with this panel, other than those small changes, but I keep finding other things that I need to go in and correct. Okay, let's go back to. Hold on. Let's go back to panel number three, which I was part of the way through working on. I did say on, I think it was on yesterday's stream, I was talking about the fact that I feel like, hold on, she's a line told. I was talking on yesterday's stream about how I feel that we're kind of getting into a good rhythm now as far as the process goes and the routine of making these pages, and that we're kind of speeding up now as a result, and I'm, a bit more productive than I was, than I have been up to this point. Once you have all the processes in place and you can minimize the sort of the planning that's required because you're doing the same sort of batch processes over and over again, then you start to be able to power through things a bit more quickly. At least this is what I'm finding. And doing each of these pages still takes some time, but not as much as it did before, so that's good. You can't complain about that. To try and keep the number of buttons on that are visible on Sadie's blazer consistent. It's two on the left side and one on the right side. Something else that has kind of been happening over the last couple of pages, and particularly on this one, is I'm starting to experiment a bit more in terms of allowing characters to, yeah, be a bit more cartoony and expressive, and part of that is just out of the need to mix things up. Yeah, if you're gonna have panel after panel of the same characters talking to each other over and over again, which is just a necessity, it seems like these we have to get through this so we can get into whatever's gonna be happening in the next scene, but we have a couple of pages that are just Kevin and Sadie talking really, and in order to break up the monotony. I don't want them to just have the same sort of expressions on every panel. So, not just the facial expressions, but the body language as well. Like, I decided on this panel that I would have Corinne, with her arms behind her back like that, kind of just further emphasizes, like, well, she's got something to hide. Or, on this particular panel, where Sadie is a bit more, I don't know what the word is I'm looking for here. She's in her pomp, I guess you could say. He's like, yeah, no more problems for us. But and so, you know, just with the eyes closed and sort of marching along. Trying to really just lean into the body language a bit more. Again, just to keep my own interest and hopefully keep the interest of the reader as well, but you don't want every single panel to just look the same. think I'm gonna have to redo this sort of armpit area because when I did the storyboard version of the image, it's like I think I was acting on the assumption that the torso was supposed to be sort of twisting, and there's nothing else in here to really indicate that it is. Everything else seems to suggest that we're looking at coming straight on, so. And I know that I haven't been saying much during this particular stream. Apologies for that. I hope it isn't impeding your enjoyment of the show. Maybe it's increasing your enjoyment of the show, I don't know. But some days I just find I have to really stay focused on what I'm doing, especially if I really want to make sure that all the details are absolutely in place. And as we've spoken about on stream before, Karen's design in particular has a lot of different components that I'm very particular about making sure are all illustrated accurately, or at least to the best of my ability. That the hair has to be a certain shape, the face has to be a certain shape. I mean, that's kind of true for all of the characters, but I think I'm a lot more conscious of it with Corinne because she's the main character, and as a result, I've had the most practice at drawing her, so. I've become that much more particular about making sure that, where possible, that she's depicted as accurately as possible. you can kind of see the difference in, I don't know, maybe it's just because I did most of Sadie's character last night and Corinne's today, but you can sort of see the difference insofar as I was very freewheeling with the line art for Sadie. The strokes are much thicker. Corinne's, I've ended up taking that much more care to make sure that she's absolutely on model, and that's kind of a problem actually because the lines are so much thinner and they almost don't look like they belong in the same comic actually. So that's a bit of an issue. I mean, I don't think it was as obvious on the previous panel where the line weight between the two characters is about the same in here. And you can really see that I'm being a lot more delicate with my lines. I'm going to let you in on a little secret about hands and the way that I depict hands, which is I always feel compelled to make sure that every finger is visible, even if the perspective doesn't actually call for it. In other words, if the hand is positioned in such a way that the finger that's furthest away from us isn't visible, I feel compelled to make sure that it's somehow visible anyway, because otherwise I think people are going to look at it and go, well, why did he give a, why does she have a finger missing? Why does she only have four digits instead of five? And then I don't know, it's like I've invented that scenario in my head. Which is not to say that there aren't times where I've almost done that. I'm sure there was at least one time a while back now where I was doing I was editing an issue of Kirby after all the art was done, and I realized that a character had six fingers, and I was oh, I was mortified. And of course, again, it didn't make it through to production, but I was mortified that I got to that late stage and I hadn't noticed it. So mistakes do happen. Okay, we're almost done with today's stream. last Club Kirby of the week. How many shows did we do this week? Three? Three, I think, because I think we did the Monday show and then Tuesday, Wednesday. I think I was occupied, as I recall, and then we did the stream yesterday and we've done today's as well, so that's three. It would be nice to have at least 1 week where we could go 5 for 5 and do a full uninterrupted week of streaming. That's still the goal, actually. We've done that before and we can do it again. And it might be that as we get more settled into this routine that I was talking about earlier, in terms of the process just gets more and more streamlined, can get more comics done more quickly, and I think that that might help as well in terms of keeping the momentum going. And we shouldn't ever be short of things to do on stream. Once this page is done, we still have to go back and layer this page and the previous page as well. We still have to, there's still the backgrounds to add as well for this and the lettering. And in fact, the plan is still that we're going to letter this page and the previous page, page 23, together, and we'll do another lettering stream. I think that's the plan. So don't be surprised if Monday's stream turns out to be a lettering stream, subject to change. Because I would really like to keep the momentum going this weekend and get some more things done. Now that hand is going to be a bit awkward because it's going to butt right into Sadie's hand, which is in the foreground. But I need to figure out how Corinne's hand is going to work there because it's holding the backpack. So I think I might have to drill through that. Or maybe do that part on a separate layer just so I can easily manage it. And then after that we'll go on and illustrate this page as well, where Kieran and Sadie are confronted by Craven, so I don't know when that's going to get done. Hopefully I can get the rest of this page done over the weekend, and if not, we'll do it on a future stream. I would really hope that I could find some time to do it, because that's, if I can't, then that's going to be pretty bad if I don't manage to get any more of this page done over the next 2 days. But that is going to do it for today's Club Kirby, and in fact this week's Club Kirby's, plural. And we should be back at the same time next week, I would imagine about 3 p.m. UK time. Another week of iZoom lettering and illustration and everything else that goes into the making of these pages. And yeah, we'll keep going. We're at the halfway, we're almost at the halfway point now, as far as I remember I said I wanted to do 50 pages before we actually start to release these to the public. So hopefully we can actually start to build some momentum now and progress towards that 50 page target. So I hope that you will join me as we progress towards that next week for more Club Kirby.